So I started cooking at home at a young age with my mum, baking cakes and then going on to Sunday roasted. And then from there grew this desire to be a chef. I worked for three Michelin star chefs. So we had the late Bernard Oiseau. And then also worked with Joël Robuchon in Germain in Paris. Again, unfortunately, recently passed away, but brilliant chefs and a great differentiation, if you like, in terms of their philosophy on food. Raymond Blanc recommended me for the head chef job at Gidley Park, which I took in 94, where I stayed, in fact, for 21 years, 18 of them holding two-star Michelin in all of those 18 consecutive years. But after 19 years, I felt 20 years is a big year coming up. What am I going to do? And so I started to look for a place to work for myself, somewhere I could create either a hotel or take on a pub. And eventually it led me to finding Caines Mansion, which is now Lympstone Manor. I think what sets Lympstone Manor apart is that it's the imagination, if you like, and creativity of myself. It's a realisation of my dream. In terms of the food, it allows me to feel free about the style of food I want to cook, champion our region, southwest in particular Devon, and make the most of this wonderful landscape. One of the dishes I'm cooking you for today is going to be pan-roasted beef fillet with a rusty potato and asparagus and a Madeira sauce. Normally I would do this dish with a bit of braise, but for today, because it's not on the menu officially, I'm just going to serve it with the prime cut of the meat. To understand how to cook something, you've got to understand the structure of the cut. So in this case, fillet being the most tender, doesn't require a huge amount of cooking. And it's about slow heat transfer, and we're doing that by not allowing the beef to touch the surface of the pan. By putting on a trivet, it allows us to get elements of aromats in there when it roasts. But ultimately, it's pan roasted to get the caramelization and then slowly finish through the oven. So the tip really is, you know, it's a kind of reverse mentality of putting it in a water bath. Madeira sauce is made using the trim. We use a veal and a chicken stock within the sauce. The Madeira really giving this time of year a note and a nod towards the mushrooms that are on the dish as well. So we've got a nice fricassee of mushrooms. And last of these, the asparagus, where there's a late season from the valley wide. So we're going to celebrate the last of the asparagus in the late crop with a little bit of sweet corn, a puree, that sort of brings in some of those elements of the autumnal notes. But sweet corn's great right now, mushrooms are coming through, and this recent spell of rain has really brought that on. That will go well with that sort of muskiness of the Madeira sauce. I think that a lot of people tend to over roast and also have too much contact heat on the skin of meat, which then leaves it to dry out. And this technique, when we roast it, will show people how to cook it in perhaps a softer way. That the beef is from Dart's Farm, where they hang it for a minimum of 4 weeks in their storage facility. The beef is actually reared by Paul Dart and finished brilliantly. Some of the best beef I've had. It's a very important part of what we do is to sell a sense of taste, if you like, which is specific to this region. And that differentiates us as well, because you can't get our product everywhere.